श्रीमती रामानंदाचार्य work is abundant of innumerable entities with various models, shapes and functions. Each and everything is destined to have a specific structure, destined to have a specific function, and also has been created in such a model that they unite with each other, having mutual symbiosis, catering to the development of a wholesome structure known as universal model or order. This proves that everything is divine, universal spirit is abundant and immanent in each and every creature, enabling each and everything to serve a cause for its own personal development, collective development, composite development, and holistic development of the whole cosmos. So we should understand this particular divinity within inside. And the symptom for divinity inside is of three things. One is being useful to some others. Number two, to be having a very strong systematic assembly. Number three, capable of processing ourselves towards progress. These three things are the symptoms by which we can understand that there is God. By means of our usage, if there is something known as utility, that is divinity. If something is developing and progressing, that is a divine urge. If something is having a systematic arrangement or an orderly presentation, that orderliness, the beauty of the orderliness is known as divinity. And this everything is understood by some basic substratum. What is the basic substratum? The substratum of each and everybody's life is the world, its mysteries, the miracles, the wonders of the world. And for understanding everything, that is a basic energy required. That basic energy is known as intelligence. That intelligence is operated by a tool known as intellect. That intellect is nothing but solidified mind which is directed towards a pathway and potential. A person's committed, directed, solidified mind is known as intellect, and memory is the ornament and coordinator of that intellect. This is how we know everything. First of all, the whole universe is packed with energy, packed with truth, packed with purpose. It is what we call ontology and teleology. It should have a base, it should have a purpose. Everything is everywhere. And how to understand and be a part of it? We require a promotive intellect. And a promotive intellect is balanced by a coordinator known as memory. So, if the person's memory is not there, serving as a bridge between a person's capability for comprehension as well as for execution or demonstration by his dexterity, the whole universal purpose will not succeed. Even it has been told that the God, who is having blemishless, eternally unfailing memory, he creates everything, sustains everything. But the memory of the God is something that is far beyond the naturality, its contractions and expansions. Sankocha vipassara hita svetara samastha vastu vilakshana swarupa jnanantamayaika swarupa. This is the name of the God. So he is the substratum of everything, he is the compendium of everything, he is the opulential contractor for everything, and he is the repository and embodiment of all transcendental appearances. As we are created by God, as the purpose is to know God, as God is immanent inside, these three things are the major understandings which we have to make to believe that memory is possible. 100% memory, not even 100% memory, 1000% of memory, eternal memory, composite memory, allied memory, exalted memory, enhanced memory, rejoiceful memory, relishable memory, emotional memory, intellectual memory, upgrading memory, all emanating transcendental memory is our birthright. It is not a special treasury or somebody's donation or some alms given to people. As we are part of God, as God resides within us, as the motto is to attain God, it is our duty to attain each and every step of God's creation. So that memory is very natural, it is spontaneous, it is fully rejoiceable, and it is our own imprinted inseparable property. So this is the basis of your contribution. In order to gather information, there are tools of observation. The gathered information are order and capability of retaining and recalling has been instilled. It is then applied for a processing known as execution. This is what we call memory. Memory serves as a mediator between a person's comprehension and execution. And to install the essential information, there are three things. To do the inputting device is the work of a teacher. To develop a memory is a self-inhibited exercise. To make it executively precise is the work of God. So a person's knowledge, which is being supported and fueled by the immeasurable potential shower and clemential grace of God. So it is a triangular coordination of Acharya, Shishya and Sarvajna. These three people, they need to form knowledge. This knowledge of the world is known as summary, and to get the hints of the knowledge is known as synopsis. To clarify all these things and classify is known as subject, and to make the subject adaptable to our own need is known as style, and to make a framework of the style is known as syllabus, and the place where it is done is known as school, and where it is incorporated and incorporated and inculcated to the students, it is known as, the persons are known as scholars, sages, seers, scientists and stalwarts. Everything comes in S. So school, stuff, syllabus, synopsis, summary, style, scholar, scholars, scientist, stalwarts, everybody goes the higher level. The person who is able to possess knowledge is a student. The possessable dosage of knowledge is known as stuff. The targeted knowledge is known as a subject. And wherever there is environmental conduciveness of competition, inspiration and culmination, that area infrastructure is known as school. So everything is a well-patented design, but now it is not so. Now the definition of a student, a school, stuff, subject, a scholar, everything is different from what it ought to be naturally as per the theory of explanation. The terminology exists, but without having the term, having the technicality inside, there is a problem. So education is, that is what they call in Shastras, education is a charity. If there is the womb of a mother in which you are biologically processed, having come out of the womb of your mother, you are getting into a second womb which is known as the school. School is the second womb, and the umbilical cord between the divinity and your physical structure is great Acharya and the master. Through that umbilical cord, each and every essential nutrient of education, each and every salubrious content of knowledge and wisdom is properly imparted. That is the second pregnancy by which we are getting into Jnanagarbha. And the delivery of knowledge is fulfillment, to be useful for one's own self, to be useful for one's own family. That's what I told yesterday in the conference, that it is for Pukshi, it is for Kurumbha, it is for Kula and it is for Kumaraya. Pukshi means for you, Kurumbha means for your dependents, Kula means for your clan, Kola means for the entire world. So these are the four stages where a person should apply the knowledge as a powerful tool. Knowledge is charity, education is a charity, which has become very commercial now. To get something and to give many a thing is known as charity. Not to get anything but give everything is also a charity. Now it has been promoted to such a level that they get everything and give nothing. That is the present system of syllabus education. So what is this memory and how to understand the system of memory? Memory is an ability. Memory is an inbuilt ability. Memory is an ability by which a person can analyze what is good and bad, how much to get, when to get, how to use all of these things, multidimensional packages, compositely known as memory. What we are having as memory is different from what it is defined as memory. So memory has vigilance, memory has productivity, memory has inbuilt genuinity, memory has inbuilt purity that is embedded inside, that which is a composite matter of talents and technicality that is coupled with a person's magnanimity, benevolence and universal embrace and brotherhood, that is known as memory. And something just you are irreplaceably, unavoidably holding with you for a compulsion, it is not a memory, it is a tremory. It is not memory. So memory is something where we have some sort of orientation, where we are having involvement, where somebody else apart from us, they are also benefited, where there is connective benefit, where there is related benefit, where there is a hierarchy of benefit for generations and generations together. If a person reads, the person only can get the knowledge. If a person learns and masters, he can give knowledge, distribute knowledge by his erudition, by his compassion, by his radiation to thousands of people and create not only schools of knowledge but generations of knowledge which will penetrate into society. Number two, there are two types of memory. One is the pre-embedded systematic and mechanic memory. For example, a lot of our biological processes are there. They are codified with the genes, they are codified with the chromosomes. There are cellular messages, there are tissue messages, there is the DNA incorporated helix compound messages, that these messages are incorporated without a person's input that is demanded from the surroundings. They are known as pre-processed, pre-determined or pre-recorded or pre-embedded memory. That is the biological. But for our development, psychological development or cognitive development, we have to process the second memory. That is known as cognitive development, whereby we observe things by perception, we understand
ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಶಾಸ್ತ್ರ ಹೇಳಿದೆ ಧ್ಯಾನ ಗ್ರಹಣ ಧರಣ ಮಿಲನ ಸಂಕಲನ ಪ್ರವಚನ ಪ್ರಯೋಗ ದೇ ಯೂಸ್ ಟು ಸೇ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ವಿ ಕಾಲ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವೇಷನ್ ಅಟೆನ್ಷನ್ ಕೀನ್ ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವೇಷನ್ ದೆನ್ ಅಸಿಮಿಲೇಷನ್ ದೆನ್ ಪೊಸೆಷನ್ ರಿಟೆನ್ಷನ್ ಕಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ರಿಕಲೆಕ್ಷನ್ ದೆನ್ ರೀ ಮೆಕಾನಿಸೇಷನ್ ಆರ್ಡರ್ಲಿ ಅಸೆಂಬ್ಲಿ ಅಂಡ್ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಷನ್ ವೆನೆವರ್ ರಿಕ್ವೈರ್ಡ್ ಏದರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್ ನರೇಷನ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಇಂಟರ್ವ್ಯೂ ಇನ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್ ರೈಟಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಗ್ರಾಫಿಕಲ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೇಷನ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಡಿಮ್ಯಾಂಡೆಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿನೇಷನ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್ ಡೆಮಾನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ದಟ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಡು ಸಮ್ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟಿಕಲ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಹಸ್ತಬದ್ಧ ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಹಾಸ್ಯಬದ್ಧ ಆರ್ ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಚಿಂತಾಬದ್ಧ ಆರ್ ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ಪ್ರಕ್ರಿಯಾಬದ್ಧ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ವೆದರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಿಕಲಿ ಟು ಬಿ ಡೆಮಾನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರೇಟೆಡ್ ನ್ಯಾರೇಟೆಡ್ ಆರ್ ಟು ಬಿ ರೀಟ್ರೇಟೆಡ್ ಆರ್ ಟು ಬಿ ರಿಟನ್ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ಇಟ್ ಮೇ ಬಿ ದ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ರಿಪೇರ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎನಿ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಡೆಮಾನ್ಸ್ಟ್ರೇಷನ್ ಎನಿ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಷನ್ ದಿಸ್ ವಾಟ್ ಪೀಪಲ್ ಮೆಮರಿ ಮೆಮರಿ ಇಸ್ ಅನ್ ಎಬಿಲಿಟಿ ಫಾರ್ ಎ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಬೈ ವಿಚ್ ಹಿ ನೋಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಹಿ ಕಲೆಕ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್ ಹಿ ರಿಟೈನ್ಸ್ ದ ಸ್ಕಿಲ್ ಸಸ್ಟೈನ್ಸ್ ಹಿಸ್ ರಿಟನ್ ಮೈಂಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕ್ಯಾಪಬಲ್ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ ವೆನ್ ಎವರ್ ವೇರ್ ಎವರ್ ಡಿಮ್ಯಾಂಡೆಡ್ ವಿತ್ ಜಾಯ್ ವಿತ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕಂಫರ್ಟ್ ಸಿ ವೆನ್ ಎವರ್ ಎ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ರಿಸರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಅಶ್ವವಿದ್ಯಾ ಐ ಕೋಟ್ ಇನ್ ಒನ್ ಸೆಮಿನಾರ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ವಾಟರ್ ಐ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಮೆನ್ಷನ್ ಅಬೌಟ್ ದಿ ಟಿಯರ್ಸ್ ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಎ ಫಾರ್ಮ್ ಆಫ್ ವಾಟರ್ ವೆನ್ ಎವರ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಈಸ್ ಕ್ರೈಯಿಂಗ್ ಬೈ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಅನ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಲೇಷನ್ ಎನಿ ಎಮೋಷನ್ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಿಲೇಷನ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫೈ ಅಕಾರ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಅಶ್ವವಿದ್ಯಾ ಶಾಸ್ತ್ರ ದಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಪಟ ದಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಕೂಟ ದಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಉದೃತ ದಟ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ವಂಚಿತ ಇನ್ನೊಂದು ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫಿಕೇಶನ್ ಅಂತಾರೆ ಇಫ್ ಎ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ರಿಟೆನ್ಷಿಯಸ್ಲಿ ಕ್ರೈಯಿಂಗ್ ಎಮೋಷನಲಿ ಕ್ರೈಯಿಂಗ್ ಕ್ರೈಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ವೀಕ್ನೆಸ್ ಬ್ರೈನ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ಹಿಸ್ ಇಂಟೆಲೆಕ್ಚುವಲ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರೆಂತ್ ಆಫ್ ಎನ್ಕಪಾಸಿಂಗ್ ಎವ್ರಿಬಡಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಗ್ರೇಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಾಲಿಟಿ ಆಫ್ ಮರ್ಸಿ ಎ ಸ್ಟ್ರಾಂಗ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಇಸ್ ಕ್ರೈಯಿಂಗ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಇಸ್ ಕ್ರೈಯಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎ ಬೆನಿಫಿಟ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಇಸ್ ಪ್ರೊವೋಕ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಸ್ಮೋಕರ್ ಆಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಆರ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅನ್ ಆನಿಯನ್ ಕಾಂಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಎವ್ರಿಥಿಂಗ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಬಿ ವೆರಿ ಈಕ್ವಲಿ ಈಸಿಲಿ ಕ್ಲಾಸಿಫೈಡ್ ಬೈ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಯ ಶಾಸ್ತ್ರ ಬೈ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಯ ಹೈಪರ್ ಟೆಕ್ನಿಕ್ ವಿಶುವಲ್ ಬೋನ್ ಲೈಕ್ ವೈಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಸಂಬಡಿ ಇಸ್ ಸ್ಪೀಕಿಂಗ್ ವೆದರ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಪೀಕಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಲಿಪ್ಸ್ ವೆದರ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಪೀಕಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಬೇಸಿಕ್ ಸೂಪರ್ ಕಾನ್ಷಿಯಸ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಆರ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಸ್ಪೀಕಿಂಗ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ದ ಸಬ್ ಕಾನ್ಷಿಯಸ್ ಲೆವೆಲ್ ಇಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಕಮ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಜಾಯ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ರೆಪಿಟಿಷನ್ ಆರ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿವಾರ್ಡ್ ಆರ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ಸಮ್ ಸಾರ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ರೀಕ್ರಿಯೇಷನ್ ಕೋಯರ್ಸಿವ್ಲಿ ಮೆನ್ಷನ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಸಂಬಡಿ ಎಲ್ಸ್ ಟು ಪ್ರೊಡ್ಯೂಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಅನ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಮಿನೇಷನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಇಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಎ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಮೋಡ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಪರ್ಟಿಕ್ಯುಲರ್ ಡೇ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಅ ಕಂಪಲ್ಸರಿ ಡ್ರಾಪ್ ಸೊ ನಾಲೆಜ್ ಇನ್ ಟರ್ಮ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಜಾಯ್ಸ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಜಾಯ್ ವೆರ್ ಎವರ್ ಸಂಬಡಿ ಸ್ಪೀಕ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ನಾಲೆಜ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೀ ದಟ್ ಬೈ ಕ್ಲೀನ್ ದಿ ಐಸ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೀ ದ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ ನೆಚರಿಂಗ್ ದಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಪೋರಿಂಗ್ ಔಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ವರ್ಲ್ಡ್ ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸೀ ದ ಗ್ರೇಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಜಾಯ್ ದಟ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಎಂಜಾಯಿಂಗ್ ಆಸ್ ಇಫ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮಿಂಗ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ನೋನ್ ಅಸ್ ಅಂಬ್ರೋಶಿಯಾ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮಿಂಗ್ ಸಮಥಿಂಗ್ ನೋನ್ ಅಸ್ ದಿವೈನ್ ನೇಚರ್ ದಿಸ್ ವೇ ಆಫ್ ಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೇಷನ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಗ್ರೇಟೆಸ್ಟ್ ಓರಿಯಂಟೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಯಲೈಸ್ಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ರಿಲಿಷಬಲ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಮಿಟಬಲ್ ನಾಲೆಜ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಎ ಟೀಚಬಲ್ ನಾಲೆಜ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಮಿಟಬಲ್ ನಾಲೆಜ್ ಫಾರ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಆರ್ ಹ್ಯಾವಿಂಗ್ ಅ ವೂಂಡ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಸೀ ಅನದರ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ದ ವೂಂಡ್ ವಿಲ್ ನಾಟ್ ಬಿ ಟ್ರಾನ್ಸ್ಫರ್ಡ್ ಇಫ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಐ ಇನ್ಫೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಇಮಿಡಿಯೇಟ್ಲಿ ವೇರ್ ಎವರ್ ದ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಸೀಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ದ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ ವಿಷ್ಣು ವ್ಯಾಪಕ ವೇರ್ ಎವರ್ ಹಿ ಗೋಸ್ ಎಫೆಕ್ಟಿವ್ಲಿ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಮೆಡ್ರಾಸ್ ಐ ಆರ್ ಎಡಿಟ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಟ್ ರಿಯಲ್ ನಾಲೆಜ್ ರಿಲಿಷ್ ನಾಲೆಜ್ ಇಸ್ ಇನ್ಫೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ರಿಯಲೈಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ರಿಲಿಷ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಡ್ವೆಲ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಅ ಸಿಟಿ ಹೂಮ್ಸ್ ಓವರ್ ಸೀಸ್ ಹಿಮ್ ಟಚಸ್ ಹಿಮ್ ಆರ್ ಆಕ್ಸಿಡೆಂಟ್ಲಿ ಕ್ರಾಸಸ್ ದ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಎವ್ರಿಬಡಿ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಇನ್ಫೆಕ್ಟೆಡ್ ಬೈ ದಟ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಡಿಸೀಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸಲಿಷಿಯಸ್ ಡಿಸೀಸ್ ನೋನ್ ಆಸ್ ನಾಲೆಜ್ ಇನ್ಫೆಕ್ಷನ್ ವಿಚ್ ಬೂಸ್ಟ್ ದ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಇಸ್ ಅ ಟ್ರಾಪಿಂಗ್ ಹಿಮ್ ವಿತ್ ಗಾಡ್ ಸೊ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಗ್ರೇಟ್ನೆಸ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಮೆಮರಿ ನಂಬರ್ ಒನ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ಮೆಮರಿ ಈಸ್ ಮೆಮರಿ ವಾಟ್ ಎವರ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಪ್ರೊಸೆಸಿಂಗ್ ನೌ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಡನ್ ಇನ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಸೈನ್ಸಸ್ ಒನ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಬೈ ಫಿಸಿಯೋಲಾಜಿಕಲ್ ಸ್ಟಡಿ ಬೈ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಪಿಸ್ಟೆಮಾಲಜಿ ಎಪಿಸ್ಟೆಮಾಲಜಿ ಇಸ್ ದ ಸೈನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೆಮರಿ ಸೆನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ನಾಲೆಜ್ ಬೈ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಪಿಸ್ಟೆಮಾಲಜಿ ದೇ ಅಡ್ವೆಂಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಸರ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ದೇ ಅಡ್ವೆಂಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಸರ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಎಥಿಕ್ಸ್ ಎಥಿಕ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ನಾಲೆಜ್ ಫಿಲಾಸಫಿ ಅಂಡ್ ನಾಲೆಜ್ ಮಿಸ್ಟಿಕ್ಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ನಾಲೆಜ್ ರಿಲಿಜಿಯಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಕ್ಟೀಸಸ್ ಅಂಡ್ ನಾಲೆಜ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮೆಮರಿ ದೆನ್ ಸ್ಪಿರಿಚುವಲ್ ರಿಯಲೈಸೇಷನ್ ನಾಲೆಜ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮೆಮರಿ ನಾವು ಸೈಕಾಲಜಿ ನಾಲೆಜ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಮೆಮರಿ ನಾವು ರೀಸೆಂಟ್ಲಿ ಕಾಗ್ನಿಟಿವ್ ಸೈಕಾಲಜಿ ನಾವು ದ ರೀಸೆಂಟ್ ಸಬ್ಜೆಕ್ಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಗ್ನಿಟಿವ್ ನ್ಯೂರೋ ಫಿಸಿಯಾಲಜಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಕಾಗ್ನಿಟಿವ್ ನ್ಯೂರೋ ಬಯಾಲಜಿ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ಕನೆಕ್ಷನ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ಬ್ರೈನ್ ನಾಲೆಜ್ ಮೆಮರಿ ಅಂಡ್ ಕೆಪಾಸಿಟಿ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಡೌಟ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಎಂಜಾಯಿಂಗ್ ಇಟ್ ದಿಸ್ ಮೆಮರಿ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಫ್ಲಾಶ್ ಪವರ್ ಬೈ ವಿಚ್ ಎ ಪರ್ಸನ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬೋತ್ ಎ ಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಅಂಡ್ ರೀಪ್ರೊಡಕ್ಟಿವಿಟಿ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಫ್ಲಾಶ್ ಆಫ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಕ್ಷಣಾರ್ಧ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಪರ್ಸನ್